Can't see outside like we can in the so right, yeah, today you don't really want to see it. Listen, I don't have anything to open up with other than I'm glad I'm here in front of them with you guys and gals, because that means we're still playing. So hopefully we can do it again next week. With that, I'll open it up.
Obviously, you're consumed with shutting down Lamar and shutting down the Ravens, but I do wonder if just from a step back standpoint, you have an appreciation for Patrick versus Lamar as a theme of this game.
Yeah, I mean, listen, this league is a lot about the quarterbacks, right? We're fortunate that in this game, we've got two of the best ones in the league. You know, all our goal and what we talk about all the time is let's just get the ball back to our quarterback. You know, that's our job, right? And the only way to do that is to make sure that their quarterback doesn't do the things we know he's capable of doing. But two dynamic players that I'm sure for TV and everybody watching this would be pretty fun.
And seeing Lamar's success last week, do you feel like you saw him take a postseason step of any sort? He's labored a little bit in the postseason until now.
Yeah, I mean, I don't put too much credence into, you know, we always put things in the rearview mirror. I ask our guys to do that, whether our performance was good or bad. I'm sure they do the same thing. And, you know, we look forward to this game, and we expect him to be as dynamic and on point as he was last week.
Coach, what's the challenge when you're expecting a star player like Mark Andrews to be back in the mix and you don't necessarily have that recent film?
That's a great point. We do think he'll play. We don't know that, but we're going to plan as if he is. And he's another weapon for the quarterback, and a trusted weapon. I mean, we've seen it. It happened early in the year, and we've seen it in previous years. We'll have to be on point. What you hope for is they're a little rusty, right? Because they haven't played a lot together. But these guys are pro athletes, and they know what they're doing. So I don't think we can completely trust that that's going to happen. Yeah, really proud of Chamari, and really in the way he's developed. When he came here, I can remember back in OTAs, it was like, whoa, it's going to take a while, you know. But because he wasn't used to some things that we were doing, and, you know, we're pretty multiple. But I'll tell you what, he has grinded at it. The vets around him have just kind of pulled him along, the LJs, and even Trent, and certainly Justin Reed, Mike Edwards back there. And he really, you know, spoon-fed him early, right? We've given him piece by piece, and then he moved to nickel, and we could see he could do some things there. So then he was out there with the guys, right? When you're here as a rookie, you're with the twos and the threes, right, in the walkthrough. And then all of a sudden, he's up there with the guys, right? And I think that gave him some confidence. He does play – you all see that. He plays fast, and he's physical. I mean, I'll take that all the time. And,
Is he beating off of the other guys as far as his aggressive?
Very much so. And he's getting a little bit more vocal. That wasn't his big thing, but he is now, because he's confident in what he's saying and seeing. And I think our guys like playing around him and trust him. That's a big thing.
Steve, how did you feel like you did against Josh Allen, the running part of his game?
Yeah.
Given all the other things you had to defend also last week?
Yeah, we would have liked to have done better. I mean, I was over there praying like heck he'd make a mistake. Yeah, he never made a mistake. He didn't make a mistake when to scramble, when not to scramble, when to throw, where to throw it to. Didn't turn the ball over. Even the one time when Chris made a heck of a play, getting out of there, got it on the ground, we couldn't get it. We would have liked to have defended him better, certainly in the first half, right, to get the ball back to Patrick a little bit more. But they were just really good at possessing the ball. The third downs early, like the first third down, that still kills me. It was third and 17 or something, right? But he makes a play. I don't know how you defend that, you know. Breaks out of there. Everybody's trying to go get the scrambling quarterback, right? And then he flicks it to, the running back. And then they get the fourth and one, and they get. But we would have liked to defend. But we certainly need to defend this quarterback better than we did last week to make things go the way we want.
Playing against him last week, did that help you?
Playing against Josh?
Yeah, did that help you properly this week or no?
Mitch just mentioned that when we had a conversation out there, Mitch Holtus, and I think there is something to that. Like, the challenge is the same. You know, quarterback that can throw it, that can run it, that can scramble, right? It's like three dimensions instead of two. And some of the things that we normally would put in a game plan for that type of quarterback were in there last week. They'll carry over to this week. And, so hopefully practicing 2 weeks and that kind of.
Piggyback on that, Lamar's a little bit of a different athlete than Josh, right? So did the principles change at all in terms of contain and stuff like that? And then also, what value would it have if Willie's healthy and ready to go?
Yeah, good point about Willie. They are different quarterbacks. You know, what we want to do to them might change a little bit. I don't want to dive too deep into it. But he's just like, if you put the film on, I mean, it's like, okay, how do you defend that? It's another one of those, right? Because there's some things he does that nobody else does. And the best thing we can do is try to contain him as best we can. To me, the best thing we did last week, if we could do this again, which is hard to do, is limit the explosive passes. I mean, I think that helps us. You know, then it makes him kind of matriculate down the field, and hopefully we can make a play somewhere along the way. The Willie thing is a really good one. I don't know where we'll be right now, but he, you know, you all know he adds a piece in passing downs. Now, as we talk about that, we got to get him in those passing downs. Last time we played this crew, I don't know, it's a different offensive coordinator, but we only had 11 third downs, and five or six of them were 1-4. We need to, that needs to change to have any kind of success or have a chance at success. So that's what we'll be trying to do. Somebody else.
Yeah, and following up on that question, actually, you know, Lamar's skill set is so unique. What have you guys been doing to sort of, you know, to obviously to replicate that skill set at practice on the scout team, and how difficult is it to simulate the speed at which they run?
It's really hard to do. We do have a guy, now I'm going to ask Sid to help me out, Chris, and I can't say Chris's last name with O. Yeah, there you go. Thank you. But he did it yesterday for us. And I would say this, we're fortunate that we have Chris. He did it last week for us. He was Josh Allen, and Blaine did a little bit of it too, but you can't simulate it. And then even in practice, Chris, you're not tackling anybody, so you're not finishing on a guy. But there are some things that we have talked about in how we should practice to prepare for him. And I think Chris gives us as good a look as we're going to get, you know, during the course of a practice week.
Yesterday, Justin Reed was telling us how the Ravens kind of take the starch out of you. You know, you may come out and playing real hard in that first quarter, but they're just kind of relentless as they go.
Yeah.
How important is it to have that energy for the four quarters against these guys in particular?
Yeah, no question. I mean, I was a little fearful last week when we played so many plays in the first half. But we found a way to get off the field a couple times in the second half. We can't get into that kind of game and those long drives like that with Baltimore, because it'll be really tough. I mean, listen, I was there in Baltimore for 2 years working with John Harbaugh. I got a tremendous amount of respect for him. He's one of the best in the league. I'm a better coach because I work for John. Where I'm going with it is I know exactly what he's telling him, you know, and it's what you're talking about. And he's built the team that way, you know, to come right at you, you know, whether it's run or pass, and just keep bullying your way downfield. So we need to be prepared for that and find a way to kind of match that with the same kind of aggressive, fast play that they do.
Thank you.
Got it all? Good. Thank you. Yep.